Protests downtown as the Pittsburgh Catholic Diocese and Bishop David Zubik are accused in a local man's death.
Team 4 investigator Jim Parsons was the only reporter inside the courtroom. He joins us here right now. Jim?
Yeah, Andrew and Wendy, those protesters that you just saw were family and friends of Michael Unglo, a 39-year-old former Aetna man who committed suicide last year. They say he killed himself for one simple reason, because the diocese decided to stop paying for his psychiatric treatment, treatment Unglo needed to deal with being sexually abused years ago by a diocesan priest. Michael Unglo's mother and sisters were among those carrying signs outside the city county building, protesting a decision by a Common Pleas Court judge to dismiss their lawsuit against the Diocese of Pittsburgh. Inside, their attorney argued their appeal before three Superior Court judges.
My brother lost his life over this. I mean, a life is a life. You can never gain it back. We are here to make sure that no other family ever has to go through what we're going through.
When leaders of a Catholic institution make severe, like, horrible decisions, there should be consequences to their actions.
The diocese agreed to pay for Michael Unglo's psychiatric care after Bishop David Zubik learned he was sexually abused as a boy by former priest Richard Dorsch in the mid-1980s. Dorsch, the former pastor of All Saints Church in Aetna, was convicted of molesting another boy and served jail time. After paying almost $400,000 for Unglo's mental health treatment, the church notified him last year it would cease payments after a final $75,000 check. 2 months later, Unglo killed himself, and his family's lawyer says the diocese knew that was a risk.
They had a letter from his psychiatrist. His family members met with the bishop, begged them, do not cut him off now, because if he knows that he's not going to have any payment for medical treatment, something terrible could happen to him. And the diocese said, we're sorry.
Lawyers for the diocese argued that Unglo had threatened suicide before the church decided to cut off his funding.
Sadly, this young man's condition was before, during, and after our assistance, significant financial assistance, was the same, and we did not worsen it.
This was not a time to pull out. It was not. He was at his most fragile state, and they walked. It's wrong. It's wrong.
And that is a key legal point the appellate judges will have to consider under the Good Samaritan law. Did the diocese worsen his condition by cutting off funding when they did? If they decide the answer is yes, Michael Unglo's family will get their day before a jury. Jim Parsons, Channel 4 Action News.